Good day to all my fellow travelers, photographers, friends around the world. Welcome to Chris Lee Travel Channel. I wish you all in good health. So, in today's episode, which is the fourth episode of my travel journeys to Guizhou, province of China, I will share with you one of the most popular travel or tourist spot in southeastern Guizhou. And the name of this popular spot is the Xijiang Miao Village, located in Leishan County between the Qingdongnan, Miao and Dong autonomous prefectures of Guizhou province. So I also will share with you the dance, the cultural dance performed by the Miao in these episodes, which will be the second section of my travelogues. Now, the area color in red in this map of China is the whereabout of the Guizhou province. And as mentioned in my earlier episode, Guizhou is a mountainous region, right, with high plateaus and dense network of river and valleys. Now, in the early years, the tourism in this province was much restricted and affected by the topographies and inaccessibility to these regions. All these restriction and obstruction are now the thing of the past. And the provincial capital of Guizhou is Guiyang, right? And as shown, located at the center of this province, as shown in this map. So the in this Guizhou map, which I'm sharing with you, right, they show the location of Qingdongnan, Miao and Dong autonomous prefectures, been highlighted between the province in yellow colors. And the location, exact location of the Leishan County is also been highlighted in this map. Okay, let's take a closer look of this simplified tourist map of Xijiang Miao Village. Now, the flatlands are mainly along the riverbank, which are the economic commercial activity are the most intense. Like main attraction of this village, mostly located on the northern bank of the rivers, up on the mid hills are the residential areas. So please note that the whereabout of this performance square, also known as dancing ground, on this map. This is a tourist map captured during my visit 10 years ago. Could you spot the differences? Now, this Miao village, as shown in this map, has been divided into four zones, or they call it PNG, and of course, with more detail of the routes between the village. This area's view of the Xinjiang Miao village will give you a clearer view of the village. You can easily spot the performance square and the river, and at the bank of this performance square, it basically is two small hills, and on the hill is full of dwellings, right? And the images of these travelogues that I'm going to share with you were taken in the year 2011, 10 years ago. Much improvement and upgrading work could have taken place at the Miao village, as China have progressed rapidly over the last decade and have made the province very much accessible both domestically as well as internationally. Now, if any of you have recently visited this village, please do update us on the latest condition of this interesting Miao village. And before I move on, right, to the travel images, let's have some knowledge of the backgrounds of this famous Miao Village. Now, Xijiang Miao Village is also popularly known as a Xijiang Thousand Households Miao Village. In Chinese, it's Xijiang Qianhu Miao Zai, to many, right? It's located 32 kilometers away from Kaili City in the Leishan County, in the Qingdongnan Miao and Dong prefectures. Now, it has been regarded as the largest Miao village in China, as well as the living museum of Miao Village. Now, the village occupies a land area of about 50 square kilometers, near to 1,000 households, with approximately 6,000 inhabitants. This is how they got the name, 1,000 households. Now, over here, this Miao village had turned into a very touristic village. Residential buildings been turned into hotels and homestays, restaurants or eatery. Now, there are many shopping streets been built around the center square and also along the river that flowing past the village. I would rate this as an overrated tourist destination by judging from some of the most recent recorded video I have seen. Now, although the village building, right, still retain many of their traditional architecture style of Miao Indian groups, but the village have lost substantially of its origin, the emblems of the village livings, the rural lifestyles and pace. It has turned touristic. Now, the location on mark on the so-called the location of the star that mark on this map again is going to be show you in the next images. So this basically is the entry point of our tour to this Miao village. So these are the scene 10 years ago, how you look like now 10 years later. I hope viewer can give me some input. Now the hotel or homestay in this village are abundance, right, and have a large variety of eatery and shop to cater for the influx of tourists, particularly during the recent years. And of course, visitors are recommended to put up a night stay at least in this village if he or she wanted to enjoy the emblems of this Miao village to the fullest. This, of course, is my personal recommendations. And this is the view of the main street, right? And you can see the building are fully built of wooden structures. And there are many more commercial streets that I'm going to share with you. Now, this is actually the view, right, of the residential dwellings on the hill slopes. And this building actually is a Xijiang Miao Museum. If you have to be there, you want to know more about the background and the culture, innate culture of Miao, of course, this is one of the best spots to visit. This is one of the elaborated, decorated Miao eatery outlets, or rather you call it a restaurant, very, very traditionally designed and decorated. This is basically a modest balcony in one of the shops. The blue shirt lady is a wax figure, it's not a real person. This is one of the entrance arches to the zone Miao Village, which, as I mentioned here, divided into four zones. Very well decorated. Now this image is a typical feature in Miao Village. They air dry and store their corns above their dwellings balcony. If you have observed enough in my earlier images, you do spot many shards corns be air dry, you know, hanging at the balcony area. More street scene of the village. This is a front view of one of the, this is still a street scene. The shop full of selling souvenir. And this is actually a candy wine shop, if I'm not mistaken. And this is basically the front view of the hotel or a homestay, so called the Yujia客栈 or Yujia Inn, right? And you pay attention to the wooden works of this overhung balcony and the roof eave above. And this shop sells all silver related items, many decorated silverware of innate Miao origin. This is a gigantic size, so-called chest lock or pendant. It looks brownish because it's not been polished. Once it's polished, it will look silvery white. And these are some other silverware. You can see the image on the right. These have been polished silverware. It must look like silver, you know, compared to earlier image. Picture frames needleworks, right, with silver embroideries. And this could be a good piece to buy back, you know, home, right, to display on your wall. And myself and my wife have a wonderful bowl of authentic clay pot soup noodle in these small eatery shops on the next day, because we put a night in this village. And you can see that the bowl of the soup noodles that she is about to eat. Now it was actually a chilly morning, you know. This hot soup of these noodles, bowl of noodles, do just fine for us, you know. A certified meal for us, basically. I still can recall the enjoyment I have while eating this meal. More street scene. You can see a mobile hawker snack store. Here you can see a lot of chefs barbecue meat steaks around. Seem to be this a popular food for the local. And in these two images, one of them is a wine shop. Of course, I do took some image of the people on the street, and you can see from this image these two elderly male people, both men and women. They are mostly dressed in black, that's what I can conclude during our visit. These duos was playing their chess game, we call it Chinese chess, on one corner of the street. And for the school kids, just after their class, they sit next to the play field in front of the school, right, and been captured in this image. Now, this is the main marketplace of this village, at the inner section of the village. You can see the mural wall have been painted with all the cultural attire of the male ethnic minorities. More street scenes, plenty of souvenir and handicraft to buy in this village. This is the sections near to the marketplace. You see the ladies is making some form of local snack using a wooden hammer. Some are mobile hawkers. And here you give a close look of the attire of this lady male ethnic minority. I spotted many beautiful ladies. I really have to say beautiful because indeed all the ladies are very, very beautiful and well dressed. And I was made to understand some of them actually is a performer, and they've been selectively picked these beautiful ladies to become performers for the cultural and dance show. They're hyper friendly, and when we want to take pictures of her, they welcome us, even allow us to selfie with them. Just pay attention to the silverware, the headwear, you know. So now we come to another section of my today episode. It's actually the cultural so-called song and dance of the Miao village. And I would like to share with you is basically of the whole performance that I have captured in still image. And I hope that I could able to share with you the music of this performance, because just looking at the image, it may not be that interesting. But while I'm searching for the images, I hope you can bear with me and just slowly go through this slideshow. Sorry, I still unable to trace the image, I mean the music. Okay, just move on with the image first, all right? So you can see that they are all well-dressed, very striking colors or costume. Okay, finally, I managed to locate the music. Although the performance is not very long, I estimate it's less than an hour, but it's a very interesting show. Now, if you want, it's actually two sessions per day, and if you want to have a good spot, right, to capture the images, please be there early. I'm using the 2470 zoom lens to capture these images. There's also a choir to perform, but most of the choir performers are of the elderly people as seen in this image. And they also solo singing. So isn't all the ladies are very pretty? Okay, that's about the end of today's travelogues. And I would like to thank you for staying until these hours with me. Please support this travel channel by subscribing, sharing, and like. Now a thumb up from you is very important to me. I would like to thank you in advance for liking and supporting my travel channel. Now, a word of advice for those who wish to see more original and down-to-earth Miao Village. There are a few Miao Village nearby that worth exploring. But not to worry, in my next episodes, I'll bring you two more Miao Villages that stand out amongst other Miao Villages in these regions. Please stay tuned and stay safe and stay strong and see you next week. And bye.